luxury lifestyle, tech tools, toys, news, hot jazz, passionate living with your host and curator, Zenobia, the touchable tech diva. And now, tech diva and the luxury lifestyle and Zenobia, the touchable tech diva.
Welcome, welcome, hello. How are you today? Welcome. It's midweek, most places on the planet. This is Zenobia here, your touchable tech diva, curating for you tech diva and the luxury lifestyle, tech tools, toys, news, hot jazz, passionate living. Let's get to work here.
Thank you.
so soothing. You know, today in Southern California, well, in LA, it's been kind of dreary in the mornings, and then it gets hot in the afternoon. So these mornings, it's been dreary and actually kind of drizzly for a June. What is that, June gloom here? So anyway, I thought that tune was like really soothing. That's called The Challenger, and that's Steve Smith, Frank Gambale, and Stuart Hamm, and that's from GHS3. And opening up the show, a tune called Vapor, and that's from a group called So Live, and the album is Breakout. Okay, Zenobia here. How are you? Okay, we're getting towards the end of spring on the Northern Hemisphere here, and about to hit summer. And so things are changing. We're all going into a different mode. And that's what I'll be doing as well, trying to change the mode here as well. Okay, yeah, thank you for watching. I haven't said thank you to you guys in a while, but thank you. And I have a request that you spread the word. Okay, spread the word. Don, can you put up my the website, please? Absolutely. And the email. And yeah, so spread the word. And I know you're either watching on your computer. You know, you can take me with you. I haven't talked about this in a while, but please take me with you. Just because you leave home and leave your desktop or leave your laptop doesn't mean that you can't at least watch or at most listen, at the very least listen in your earbuds or hands-free. I'm on this thing about being hands-free. So we're streaming live, and I believe in doing live. Now, a lot of people say, oh, you need to do, you know, just record it and then go back and, you know, edit it and make it all perfect and all pretty and all of that. And that's for some people. I go for it. Okay, so I go for it. And fortunately, I had really, really good engineers here. Don is with me now. Hi, Don.
Hey.
Next time we'll put a camera on you. I'm going to slip in a picture of her. And Chris was wonderful. Chris has gone on to do his love, which he told me that was his love. So you got to go and do what you're passionate about, because, you know, that's what the show is about. Is creating efficiencies with technology for you to go out and do your passion. Because passion is a new survival tool, you guys. Think about it. Think about it, how you need something to offset and something that you really, really care about so you can do the stuff that you don't care about so much, but you gotta do, and you know what I'm talking about there. Anyway, yes, so you can take me with you on your smartphone, okay? 2/3 of the world have smartphones now. So if you're in that 1/3, well, it won't be long before that's the only thing you'll be able to buy. My prediction is that there'll only be smartphones on the market in probably about 2.5 years or less. Okay, so you'll only be able to buy some form of smartphone, maybe not a $900 smartphone. There are some smartphones that you can get for free depending on what your plan is. And so you will be having a smartphone so you can download these apps. And we're apps, just to review. They're programs that operate specifically on your phone. And if you're in the Apple iOS ecosystem, it will work on your phone and on the tablets, okay, the iPads, okay? And so these are programs or apps. There are over 3 million apps out there now for all of the platforms. That's like for the Android platforms as well as the iOS. There are over 3 million apps out there. So that says a lot about finding efficiencies and figuring something out to where you can develop an app that can conveniently be on your phone. So for you to watch this show and this Tech Diva live on Wednesdays, on most places on the planet, you download the Ustream app. Okay, so I've had other shows, go back and watch the shows TechDivaTV.com has a bunch of shows, and you can watch those shows because I do talk about different things that you can learn to do. And one of them was to download the Ustream app onto your smartphone. Okay, and then when you open up the Ustream app, you go to the search window. You know, now everybody should know the search is the little magnifying glass. Okay, the little magnifying thing that represents search, because there's not enough space for words to tell you search here. Okay, there's symbols now. There's a lot of symbolism going on in this new digital world. And anyway, you type in rmconair.com. I'm sorry, RMC On Air channel. It's three words, channel, and then you'll see the RMC On Air channel come up. And then when you click on that, it'll say live, and then you click the play button, and there you are. You're taking me with you. So that you can pass on to your friends as well, because while you're out and about having lunch, having a nice lunch someplace with a friend, tune me in and show them this Tech Diva. Okay, there you go, wherever you are. Okay, play a little bit more music, and then I'm getting a couple of graphics for you today. I had an incident happen. Actually, it happened a couple of times, which I think that you guys need to be aware of. And I'm going to talk some about, you know, I'm on this whole security thing. So one of these days, I'll be able to get off the whole security thing and talk about other stuff. You can, Don, can you put up the email also, please? TDLLshow@techdivatv.com. Okay, TD, there it is. Okay, email me the topics that you would like for me to talk about. Then you can get me off of this whole security thing. But, I mean, that's a big issue. But if there are other topics that you would like to have some information about, then email me, okay? That's a good thing. And then, of course, I'll be happy to accommodate you. Because if you're asking, there's probably others that are interested also. So there you go. Okay, so I'm going to talk about this two-step verification, how to make yourself more secure with your passwords. Okay, a little bit more music. We're going to do Antoine. I love Antoine. And I'll be back in a bit. Noel Pointer. Oh, he's hot. Okay, the tune is called Fantasia with the PH instead of an F. Fantasia. And that's from the album Fantasia. And prior to that, Antoine, a really cute little song. Antoine, and that's from a group called Garage Atois. And that's from an album called Outremer, and that's a soundtrack for a motion picture. I haven't looked up that motion picture. I'm going to have to find that because I'm real curious about what it's about. Okay, so before I talk about the two-step verification and why I think that it's significant, now I'm paying attention to it. Before, I thought it was too much trouble, but I actually took the time to actually do that. But before I do that, I want to talk a little bit about what you're doing with listening to radio these days. And this is I'm talking specifically about in the U.S., but it's happening everywhere around the globe. Okay, so you know, radio, let's talk about that for a couple of minutes. Our radios are broken up into two bands, the AM band and the FM band, at least here in the States. Okay, they call them something else in other countries, but essentially there are multiple bands and they deal with certain frequency ranges. I'll do it over here so you can see my hands. Certain frequency ranges for each one. Well, and I'm sure you've all have seen towers, which are receivers, okay? I did a show way, way back, and I talked about the whole process of how audio and radio and TV audio is transmitted, because you have to have a transmitter and you have to have a receiver. So these towers that you're used to seeing, these really tall towers on the top of hills or mountains, they catch the signal. And up until a few years back, those send out the signals in an analog fashion. Well, you know, we're all digital now. Now you know what the word digital means. It's like a whole zero and one process algorithm where the sound, everything is turned into zeros and ones, into bits. And the bits are getting tinier and tinier and tinier, so that now you can send a lot of information in a little bit of pipeline. Okay, so that's how radio essentially works. And of course we have radio in our cars, okay? And so radio had to change. They were kind of late in changing over to digital, but there are a lot of digital radio channels now, especially here in the States. You can, well, it's just like digital television. If you have a regular over-the-air digital TV converter box, okay, if you're on one of those, you'll see the normal channels here in the States. You'll see the normal channels here in LA. It's the 2, 4, 5, 7, 11, 13. You'll see those channels. But a lot of those channels have sideband channels, additional channels. So you'll see 2.1. And then it's a whole different set of TV, you know, content there. Or 4.4. Okay, here the channel 4 is NBC, and so they'll have 4.1, 4.2, 4.3. I've forgotten how many they have. But like the 4.2 is dedicated to all sports. And so the years where, in the previous years where NBC had the Olympics, the contract to broadcast the Olympics, they would put the Olympics on like the 4.2, I'm just saying it was 4.2 channel, and run that all day long, and it wouldn't interfere with their regular content. Well, radio finally went to that with their digital, with HD radio. It's called HD radio instead of digital radio. It's HD radio, to where if you have your normal channel, say you have like a 103.5 here, there may be a 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, and there's other content there. It may even be a Spanish language channel or some other language channel or completely different content altogether. Okay, so, but a lot of people do not have the radio receivers that can pick up all of those extra channels. Okay, so if you get just your standard radio or stereo in your car. Well, now it's not even just a stereo because now, you know, you got all of the information on the screen and the newer cars. Well, but a lot of people at home, they don't have the receivers, newer receivers, that pick up all of these stations, because most of the times they're not listening to their radio at home anyway. They're watching their computer on their TV. Now you've got these smart TVs. And even with that, even with their cable subscriptions, you're able to get music channels. And so people would just listen to that. They didn't realize how much content is on a radio. And so now the numbers of radio listening have been impacted by all of the online music content like Pandora and Spotify. So I picked up this article from Rain News. Rain is one of my go-tos for online broadcasting. And so they had an article just a couple of days ago, actually yesterday, and it talked about how Spotify free, okay, compares to the radio reach in four major U.S. markets. So I'm just going to talk about this in terms of the U.S. markets, but it's happening all over. Okay, so let's talk about what Spotify is. A lot of you know about, now you know that you can go on the internet. There are internet radio channels, basically internet radio channels or internet music channels. Okay, all kinds of people are trying to get into that space. Even your celebrities are trying to get into that online music space. Okay, and I won't go there right now. One of these days I'll do a show and I'll kind of compare all of these different music systems, you know, online music systems. But the popular ones here, two of the most popular ones, they're not the only ones, are Pandora, and that's global now too. Pandora, Spotify, I believe came from the UK. It didn't start out in the US, but they came to the US just a few years ago, and they have like hundreds of millions of followers. And so a lot of these online music services, they have a free service, but it's commercial driven, so you see commercials. Okay, or not see on the radio, you're gonna hear commercials. You'll see a still graphic on your phone or on your computer. That's an ad also. And then now you know there's Apple Music. Apple used to have Apple Radio, which was free, which was like wonderful, but they decided to roll that into Apple Music and make you pay. I think they should have kept at least a free channel. Okay, but now you have to pay for any music or radio, and there's radio stations there. So Dr. Dre has a really popular radio station on Apple Music. Pharrell, I think he has his own channel, or at least I've seen him a lot on. So there's a lot of celebrities that are flocking to that, but you have to pay a subscription. What is it, like $10 a month or $9.95 or whatever it is? They make you pay. Now it's not just so that you have an ad-free experience, but they just make you pay, okay, to access that premium content. Okay, so needless to say, there are a lot of you, and they figured out that you will pay. Okay, you will pay. Since they know you will pay, you will pay. And but at the same time, there's a lot of people that, you know, a lot of you are paying. So, you know, for premium. And so you're more driven to do that, to pay, than for listening to free radio nowadays. But it's kind of changing some. Okay, so in this article, this has a really interesting take, which I thought it was really interesting. So, you know, just to give you a little taste of this. The title, and you can go to rainnews.com. You can email me if you really want to get the whole complete link. But if you go to rainnews.com and search on Spotify, then you'll probably come to this article, because URL is way too long for me to read. Okay, but it's typically the title, How Spotify Free Compares to Radio Reach in Four Major U.S. Markets. So Spotify does have a free version, just like Pandora has free. And, you know, they interject commercials in there every now and then. Okay, and this came out yesterday. This week, Spotify is releasing the newest edition of its ongoing consumer survey that seeks to measure listening reach. Okay, so all of them are doing surveys to see how many of you guys are listening. Okay, and when. Okay, specifically, how Spotify Free compares to local AM FM radio. Spotify Free is the radio-like, ad-supported free listening tier, which complements the Spotify premium subscription service. Okay, so they have a link where you can go and look at all of that. Okay, so the research performed by Kantar-owned TNS, that's a survey company. There's a lot of new survey companies out there. My little play niece is doing really well with her survey company that she's doing. And she's working on finishing her PhD in statistics. Okay, so there's a career there. That's picking up because everybody wants to know what your numbers are. Okay, so and following up earlier studies conducted in Europe, this reveals that Spotify Free places within the top 10 radio stations in weekly reach for each of four markets studied. And these four markets were Los Angeles, New York, Chicago, and Dallas. Okay, so internet only Spotify Free places in the top 10 of the stations that are listened to among traditional radio stations. So that's very interesting. Okay, more to the point, Spotify Free is shown to provide unduplicated reach, which complements traditional radio. Okay, so what that means is that what Spotify Free is actually playing isn't being played on those other nine stations. And so it's a different set of content in addition to traditional, you know, playlists or whatever the other nine stations are playing, which is very interesting. Okay, Spotify's message to advertisers and their buying agencies use radio and Spotify Free to maximize marketing campaigns. Okay, so that's what got my attention. It's not, and I can go into a little bit more. I'm gonna just list off just a little bit with the age groups. But that's really interesting because for you, they're saying to the advertisers, because there are some people, there are a lot of people who are still doing the free. There's millions and millions of people who are still listening for free, okay, and are not making that another bill. So therefore, advertisers need to be there as well. And so with Spotify Free, what they're saying is that don't make us pit us one against the other with your ad buying dollars. Buy us both. That's basically what they're saying, is that because what we're doing on Spotify Free, I'm acting like I'm them, compliments, yeah, I'm trying to get a job, compliments the regular traditional radio buy. So you might as well hit them both at the same time. And I find that very, very interesting. So you can look to that and find more advertisers on the free versions of Spotify or Pandora, because they're going to team up with not rejecting traditional advertising on radio, but use radio also. Okay, so I think that's like really, really a cool concept as a businesswoman. You as a viewer, well, you know, we still suffer from the ads, but they're going to happen anyway. And they know that you'll pay, so you just go and pay. Okay, so fleshing out that thesis, this report describes a day part profile of radio that is in the morning hours, the peak morning hours, and Spotify Free peaking in the evening. So they're kind of reverse. Okay, so people will be in their cars going to work, and they'll listen to regular radio in the mornings when they're going to work. Okay, but in the evening when they get home, when they're doing dinner, then they switch over to internet music, right? Okay, that's what this is pointing out, and that's complementary, so they don't conflict with each other. People are doing both. Okay, this was the case in all four of the markets, which showed a big radio listening spike during morning drive. Well, we already know that. Okay, then a slow engagement fade broken by a less dramatic gain of listeners during the evening commute. Okay, so just like what I said, you're kind of switching off. You're not listening to radio in the evening. You probably want your stress relieved. So you should be playing my shows back in the evening for stress relief. Okay, and you're switching over to whatever content or music you want to listen to on the internet. Okay, so that kind of makes sense. Okay, so check yourself. How are you listening to your music? How are you listening to radio? And how are you listening to online internet radio? Okay, think about it and you'll probably see some kind of a trend there. Okay, so I just want to point out that here's how the breakout is of the listeners, as U.S. listeners, according to age. I didn't get a chance to put this graphic up, but in the age group 15 to 34, 69% are doing Spotify free. So they're doing internet based. And you know why? Because they're walking around with earbuds on with their phones. Okay, so that makes sense. And 42% are listening on real radio. Okay, so maybe they're in their cars or I don't know. Okay, and then we jump to the next tier, the age bracket 36 to 64, it switches. Okay, it flips 20% and the numbers are less. 20% are listening to Spotify free and 41% are listening on regular radio. Okay, so now that's, we're trying to see how age changes it as well. So the younger the listener, the more they're here. Okay, how many of them have radios in their rooms? Probably 5%. That's why. So this all kind of makes sense, and it shows how we're buying and what devices we're using and how we rely on them. Okay, so then the next bracket is 65 and older. It's even smaller. It's only 6% that are listening on internet or listening to Spotify free, and 17% are listening to radio. So 65 plus, they're not even listening to anything, really, any music or any radio base. So I find that very interesting. So think about your listening habits and think about, you know, there's other ways to listen and check out these. There's radios out there that you can buy. Well, receivers. See, the problem is that a lot of you are not buying audio systems and you're not buying AV receivers where you would have all of these different channels on there. And now those come smart also, just like the smart TVs. Okay, and they're Wi-Fi enabled, so you can get all the internet channels right there as well as all of the HD radio channels. Okay, so it's all being built in. And so that's where I see that a lot of people, they don't have audio video receivers in their homes. You know, they may do like the little Bose and all they're doing is connecting, you know, their phone and just playing on their phone. So that's how you miss out on some of the rich content that is out there on radio, and that's where this kind of makes a difference. Okay, I gotta play, speaking of music, another song, please. And this is my man Marcus Miller. It's called Cousin John. I'll be back in a minute. Zenobia here, the touchable tech diva, making all of these statistics touch you and how they're in your household here at Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle, tech tools, toys, news, hot jazz, passionate living. See you in a bit. Oh, Okay, yes, Cousin John, that's Marcus Miller, and that's from M2. That one's really hard to find because I tried to buy the whole thing, but I heard it on Pandora. But I wasn't able to find it, so I have to hunt around some more to actually go back and find, because I wanted to buy the whole album. Okay, so now I talked about the fact that I wanted to talk about this two-step verification. I just have a couple of minutes. Okay, what happened that prompted me to do this, and I'm just going to run through it really quickly, and you can email me if you want some more help with this. But if you have a Gmail address, and sometimes you should probably see an email that says, okay, an attempt to log in. What is it? An attempt to, there was an attempt to log in on your account that we stopped. Okay, so I have like one Gmail account because I needed to have that just to set up my YouTube so I could put my shows on a business YouTube channel. Okay, there's a whole thing to that. Okay, so I got that like a few weeks ago, and then I got one last week, and then I got another one while I was actually on my phone, and I knew it wasn't me. Okay, the other times, the time before, I knew it wasn't me either, because sometimes it'll, in Google, it'll let you know when you're on your laptop and when you're on your phone. Okay, and it'll say that, you know, you were logged in here. It'll have the time, it'll have the location. That's why I don't like to use Google, because they have too much information. But it's gonna happen. Okay, so anyway, that caused me to say, okay, I think I need to buff up and actually do the two-step verification. Okay, so Don, put up the first picture real quick. Okay, so if you go into your Google, into Google Plus, like mail.google.com, and go into your account, and where it says signing in, you can go in there and it'll say two-step verification. So I'm going pretty quickly. Okay, so Don, put up number two. Okay, and then you have options for what your second step is. And you can have them to text you or send you a voice message. Okay, the one that says number two.
This is number two.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Yes. Yeah, let's see. So, okay, so on this one, it says that there are certain devices, like on your regular computer that you use, you don't need to do two-step verification. So it'll let you know that there are some devices that you don't need to have that on. Okay, so you can be texted a code. Okay, go to the next one. You can be texted a code, or you can get a set of codes that you can go through and use that one particular code to log into your account. Yes, it's another step, but because Google is like everywhere and they're a target, I say do two-step verification. So I'm running through these kind of quickly. I'll try and do this another time as well, because I think this is very important, and I decided to back these up. You can print these codes out and keep them somewhere safe, so then when you do log in and you are close to those codes, then you can grab a unique code. Otherwise, okay, you can go back to me, Don. Otherwise, you can just set it up so that you are texted a code, and it happens like instantly, so it doesn't slow you down really, and then you can log into your account. Yeah, if you think that, if you see that message a whole lot, then you need to do something more. And there are a lot of sites like PayPal where you can do two-step verification, because that deals with money. I say consider it when money, when your money is involved, then you want to do two-step verification and just do the extra step here. Okay, get over it. Okay, I know I ran through that really quickly. My time is done for today. I'm releasing you back to whatever you were doing before you watched me, and have a good rest of your week. Do your homework. I gave you some stuff that you can research and do some homework on, but go out and listen to some really cool live music. Make it jazz if you can. Other than that, just do it. Okay, Tech Diva here. Zenobia, the touchable Tech Diva, touching technology for you here at Tech Diva and the Luxury Lifestyle. Tech tools, toys, news, hot jazz, passionate living. Take care. See you next time.